Welcome back. So as we have discussed about crystal field theory, so this is about the electronic configuration or the distribution of d electrons in T2g and Eg sets in strong octahedral field and weak octahedral field of the complexes. So what is, how do you approach for this? Again, I'll just revise few things. For electronic configuration, this D4, these electrons are distributed as T2G3 and Eg1. So this is the electronic configuration for D4 orbital. Here it is when this delta O is less than P. So ligands for which delta O is less than P. What is this delta O? This delta O is nothing but the crystal field splitting parameter. That is 0.6, 0.4 dq or delta O, crystal field splitting parameter. And what is this P? P is the pairing energy. P is pairing energy. Pairing energy which is needed to pair up the electron. Pairing energy to pair up electrons. Okay, so when this delta O is less than P, the electronic configuration for this D4 can be written as T2G3 and Eg1. So this is so when delta O is less than P. So you remember this thing, yeah? These conditions are very important. And this is so when the ligands are weak field ligands. And when the ligands are weak field ligand, they will form high spin complexes. So just remember this thing. Delta O is less than P. So the configuration will be like this, T2G3, Eg1. Okay. And this is so when the ligands are weak field ligands. With the fourth electron from this D4 electronic, D4 orbital, it 1, 2, 3 electrons. Electrons will be accommodated into Tg orbital, T2g orbital, and the fourth will be accommodated. It will go to the next one, that is Eg set of orbitals. This is so when the ligands are weak field ligands. I'll discuss this in more detail further, and it will form high spin complexes. So what should be remembered here? That is delta O is less than P. This is the case when the ligands are weak field ligands and will form high spin complexes. Okay. Now, when this delta O is greater than P, means if this value is more than this pairing energy, which is required to pair up electrons, the configuration will be T2G4 and there will be nothing in this Eg set of orbitals. Okay. So, why this is so? In this case, the configuration for this same D4, it is T2G3. And Eg1, while in this case, when this delta O is greater than P, the configuration will be T2G4 and there is nothing in this doubly degenerate Eg set of orbitals. This is because it becomes energetically favorable for the fourth electron, this fourth electron here, to occupy T2G orbital when the ligands for which delta O is greater than P means these are called as the strong field ligands and they will form the low spin complexes. Means this pairing energy is less. So when the less energy is required, so it will be rather easier for this fourth electron rather than going into this another set of orbital, which is comparatively having the higher energy than this T2G1. Where will it go? It will just accommodate it into this T2G orbital itself and those will be paired up. Okay. So, you just remember here, when delta O is greater than P, the configuration will be like this, T2G4 and Eg0. When delta O is less than P, it will be T2G3, Eg1. Means fourth electron will be accommodated into the higher energy orbital, that is Eg. That is a doubly degenerate set of orbitals. Okay. So in this case, when this delta O is greater than P, so these ligands are known as the strong field ligands, and they will form low spin complexes. And when this delta O is less than P, these will be weak field ligands, and they will form high spin complexes. So this is, again, can be explained by this table which I made here. Now this is the distribution of d electrons in T2G and EG set in strong octahedral ligand field. So whenever it is a strong octahedral ligand field, it will always form low spin complexes. Low spin complexes mean delta O is greater than P, that is the pairing energy. This value is more. So when this delta O is more, means this difference between these splitting, it is more. Because what is this delta O? This is nothing but a crystal field splitting parameter. So the value for this delta O is large. So these T2G and EG orbitals, they are far more away from each other. Okay. So if this is the case, then they will form low spin complexes. So we just remember, for this strong octahedral ligand field, delta O is more than this P. And why they are forming this low spin complexes, this can be seen from this last column here. So let us go one by one. For this, we are talking about this strong octahedral ligand field where delta O is greater than P. So when this the ligand field is strong, so obviously this gap, energy gap, is more between this T2G and EG orbital. Okay, it means that. So then how does this energy gap between this is more, how does it affect the spin of the complex? This can be seen here. So let us discuss about this. If it is a D1 configuration, the only electron, it will go to this T2G set. This is the T2G set, this is the EG set of orbital. So there is only one here. For this D2, it is one and the two. We have to follow Moon's rule here. Then when it is a D3 configuration, each of this T2G will occupy 1, 1, 1. So this is the configuration for D3. Now the question arises when the fourth electron comes. Now this fourth will be 1, 1, 1 will be accommodated, and the fourth, instead of occupying this EG set of orbital, it will pair up here and it will be accommodated into this T2G set of orbital itself, because the ligand is a strong octahedral ligand. Okay. So in this case, this delta O, and another reason is that this delta O, the energy gap between these two is large. So rather than accommodating this 1, 2, 3 here, and rather than this fourth electron going to this upper level, what will happen? That the fourth electron will be accommodated into this T2 set of orbital. So it will be paired up here. So here you can see this is paired up one. This is happening because this gap between these two energy levels is large. Okay. And why this is large? Because the ligand field, it is a strong one. So when it is paired up, so obviously this pairing energy is less, means less energy is required to pair up the electron. So it is always a very obvious thing that if the less energy is required, that will be a more stable thing. So rather than going to this EG set of orbital, which is far away from this level, T2G energy level, so it will be, the fourth electron will be accommodated in here itself, and it will be paired up, because again this pairing energy will be required in less amount. Okay. So this is the configuration. It will again will be empty here. Now how many number of unpaired electrons are there? Here two. In this case, here there are three. In this case, if there are two, here there is only one. You can see easily. Now when it is a T5 configuration, so 1, 2, 3, and the fourth and the fifth electron will be paired up here, rather than going into this EG set of orbital. Again, the region is the same as I discussed just now. So there is only one unpaired electron in this configuration. When it is a D6, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So while writing this configuration, you always have to write this way. Huh? This 1, 2, 3, and the 4th, 5th, and the 6th. Okay. So in this way, you'll have to write the configuration following Hund's law. So there is no unpaired electron, 0 here. When it is D7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then the 7th electron will go into the higher energy level. That is the EG set of orbital, which is a doubly degenerate one. So here there is only one electron, unpaired electron. D8, after accommodating or completely filling this, all the three T2G orbitals, then the remaining will go into the higher one, higher set of energy level. Then there are two unpaired electrons. Here there is 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay. When in case of D10, 6, 8, and 10. Okay. So here in this case, there is one unpaired electron, there are zero unpaired electrons. So this, the resulting spin can be calculated as S. What is this S? S means the resultant spin of the complex. So S equals to N by 2. So when it is, just substitute the values for this N, N is the number of unpaired electrons, and divide it by 2. So you'll get the resultant spin of the complex. So it is 1/2, 3/2. Here it is maximum. So if you look at these values here, the maximum value here, it is 3/2. Most of the values, they are either 1/2, 0, or maximum here it is 3/2. So they tend to form low spin complexes in case of strong octahedral ligand. Right? Because this delta O value is more and pairing energy is less. Okay. So I circled this one, D1, D2, D3, and D9 and D10. This is the case we are talking about the strong octahedral ligand. Now just go to the next slide comparatively. You just remember these configurations of 1, 2, 3, and 9, and 10. Now the next one. This is the table for distribution of D electrons in T2G and EG sets in weak octahedral. So when it is a weak octahedral field, means delta O is less than P. Means this value, this energy gap between this T2G and EG set of orbital, this is small compared to the strong field octahedral field, strong octahedral field events. So as this is the smaller value, this delta O is less than P. So now look at the configuration. Here D1, this is the configuration. For D2, this is the configuration. D3, this is the configuration. Accordingly, the number of unpaired electrons you can see easily. Then the D4. Now say this is the weak octahedral field and this energy gap between these two is smaller one. So the fourth electron, rather than pairing up, it will go to the next set of orbital, that which is a doubly degenerate one, that is an EG set of orbital, and it will be accommodated here. So just go to the earlier slide. In case of the strong octahedral field, this was the electronic configuration for D4. So this fourth electron, it has been accommodated here only, rather than going to this set of orbital. So this is the main difference between the strong octahedral ligand field and weak octahedral ligand field. Now go to the weak octahedral ligand field, D5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So you can see there are maximum number of unpaired electrons. For this D6, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this 1, 2, 3, 4, and the 5th and the 6th ligand, it will be accommodated this. Okay, then for D7, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the 7. When you write the configuration for this, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and the 5th, and then there will be pairing. Okay, because as this gap is smaller one, so this level is singly occupied. This is also singly occupied, and then the pairing starts up according to Hund's law. Because this gap is smaller one. And this, why this gap is small? Because it is a weak octahedral here. Now this D8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So D9, this is the configuration. For D8, this is the configuration. Now the circle one, whether it is a weak octahedral field or whether it is a strong octahedral field, if we look at the resultant spin in this 1, 2, 3, and 9 and 10, that is half and zero, these values, these are same as for the strong octahedral field. So the resulting spin and the number of unpaired electrons in case of D1, 2, 3 and D9 and D10, it doesn't affect whether it is a weak or strong octahedral field. Okay. So you can see here, these are the same value. This is half 1, half 0. So we'll go to the earlier slide. Here, this is half 1, 3 by 2, and this is half 0. So here again, half 1, and I missed this, the third one. This is the third one also. Half 1, 3 by 2. It was same in the earlier slide also. So whether it is a strong or a weak octahedral field, these configuration are not affected by this ligand feed. 1, 2, 3, and the 9 and the 10. Now the maximum spin for this here, it is 5 by 2. And in case of strong octahedral ligand field, the maximum it was 3 by 2. It means that these complexes are low spin complexes, because here the resultant spin is a quite a smaller one. Whereas in case of the weak octahedral ligand field, the spin of the complex, resulting spin of the complex, is comparatively a higher one for this particular configuration, like D4, D5, D6, D7. If you look at this one, for this D6, it is 2 in case of weak octahedral field. And just look, have the look. For this D6, here it is 0 resultant spin. So that is why these complexes are known as this, with the weak octahedral field, they form high spin octahedral complexes, because the spin of the resulting spin of the complex is having the greater value. Okay. So weak octahedral field means they form high spin complexes. This is the high spin complexes. High spin. So just remember two things here. Delta O is less than P, then high spin, and it is a weak octahedral. So just remember 1, 2, and 3. This will be helpful for you to solve MCQs based on this. Whenever it is a strong one, that is strong, low spin, and delta O is greater than P. Okay. So in this way, now the next one, splitting of d orbitals in tetrahedral distribution. So this we studied for the octahedral complexes. Exactly opposite is the case for the tetrahedral complexes. This EG set of orbitals, they will occupy the lower level, and T2G will occupy the higher level. Okay. And this difference is also reversed here. So this difference is minus 6DQ. So as I told many a time, it means that it is below this average level, and this is plus sign means above the average level. Okay. So this is EG in case of tetrahedral, and for octahedral it is T2G. So this diagram for this octahedral complex, it is completely reversed in case of tetrahedral. Okay. So this crystal field splitting parameter, which is T stands for tetrahedral. It is equal to 4 by 9 delta O. So it is quite a smaller one. Splitting up the orbitals in tetrahedral crystal field, it is much less compared to that of octahedral environment. So this is delta T, this is T actually, equal to 4 by 9 delta O. So tetrahedral complex is roughly, tetrahedral complex, TD means tetrahedral complex, is roughly 4 by 9, the delta O in octahedral complex. OH means octahedral complex. I'm using the short formula. Okay, so this is about the distribution of the electrons in T2G and EG sets in strong and weak octahedral ligands. In the next video, we'll talk about the calculation of crystal phase stabilization energy. Thank you.